5 evil killer cults.
5.
The Vampire Clan. 16-year-old Rod Farrell was obsessed with vampires, even claiming to be a 500-year-old vampire called Visago. When Farrell met Heather Wendorf at school, she was fascinated by him and his vampire clan. The pair performed rituals in which they would drink each other's blood. After Farrell moved back to Kentucky, Wendorf confided in him that she was miserable at home. Farrell soon came up with a solution to save Wendorf. On November 25, 1996, Farrell and his vampire clan, which consisted of Scott Anderson and 2 teenage girls, drove to Wendorf's home. The girls took the car and brought Wendorf to see her boyfriend so she could say goodbye. Meanwhile, Farrell and Anderson walked into the house, and Farrell grabbed a crowbar and beat 49-year-old Richard Wendorf to death as he lay asleep on the couch. The pair claimed they were going to leave 54-year-old Ruth unharmed, but she came across the 2 teenagers in her home and threw hot coffee on Farrell, which angered him into beating her to death as well. Farrell then burned his symbol, the letter V, into Richard Wendorf's body before stealing his car and picking up the girls. Heather's sister found the bodies when she returned home from work that night. The vampire clan drove to New Orleans, but they quickly ran out of money. When one of the girls called her mother to ask for cash, the police quickly tracked down the clan. All but Heather Wendorf confessed to the crime. Farrell was given a death sentence, making him the youngest person on death row at the time. Heather Wendorf was acquitted of involvement in the crimes after a grand jury found that she didn't know what Farrell intended to do. 4. The Carney Cult. Jimmy Pennock, Mark Goodwin, and brothers Keith and David Lawrence were involved in a satanic cult while working at a traveling carnival. Co-worker William Ault wanted to join them, and when the cult rejected him, he turned to blackmail. He knew about the murder of an 18-year-old boy in Fulton County, Georgia, committed by Pennock and Keith Lawrence earlier that year. However, the cult had a different plan to ensure Ault wouldn't talk. The 5 men were driven to a secluded area where Ault was told to lie on a makeshift satanic altar. The 4 cult members then tied and gagged him. Keith Lawrence said a prayer to Satan before Pennock picked up a knife and cut Ault from his neck to his stomach. The men then took turns cutting his abdomen and chest, making an inverted cross. Finally, Pennock asked Ault if he was ready to die before slitting his throat. 4 men later cut off Ault's head and hands and tried to burn them before throwing his body into a field. Then they took the money Ault had on him and went to Arby's. The police were tipped off to the whereabouts of the body, and the 4 cult members were arrested and charged with murder.
3.
The Russian Teen Satanic Cult. In the mid-2000s, in the Russian town of Yaroslavl, a group of teenagers led by Nikolai Ogolobayek started sacrificing small animals to Satan. One of the cult members claimed that after they started praying to Satan, his life got better. In June of 2008, the group of now around 8 17 to 19-year-old teenagers told their parents that they were going to a music festival. But in fact, they were luring 4 teenagers into a forest where they proceeded to force them to drink alcohol before brutally murdering them. Early reports claimed that the victims had been stabbed 666 times. The cult reportedly also cannibalized the corpses before throwing the arms and legs into a pit with satanic markings on it. After the bodies were found, the cult members were charged with murder, although one member was deemed unfit for trial and was ordered to undergo psychiatric treatment.
2.
Jeffrey Lundgren's Farm. Jeffrey Lundgren was a minister with the Reorganized Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, a large offshoot of the Mormon religion. He was removed due to concerns about his radical views and eccentric behavior, as well as accusations of theft. He moved his family to Kirtland, Ohio, where he started his own cult. He forced his followers to give him their paychecks and participate in mandatory weapons training. In order to maintain his rule, he listened in on phone calls and banned cult members from talking to each other. Things escalated when Lundgren announced that women could achieve salvation through sexual acts. He had them dance naked while he watched and masturbated. Things came to a head when the newly joined Avery family decided that they wanted to leave. To stop them, he started up a chainsaw and left it running in order to mask the gunshots and killed the whole family. The cult disbanded after this, and when the bodies were found, the law eventually caught up with Lundgren, and he was executed by lethal injection in 2006.
1.
The Ripper Crew. This satanic cult operated out of Chicago during 1981 and 1982, performing a series of brutal rape murders. Led by a former John Wayne Gacy employee named Robin Geck, the cult would kidnap women and mutilate and cannibalize their corpses, as Geck read aloud from the Satanic Bible. Their reign of terror came to an end when the group kidnapped prostitute Beverly Washington. They raped her, stabbed her, and removed her breast before dumping her by the railroad tracks. Amazingly, Washington survived the brutal ceremony. She gave the police a description of the men who attacked her, as well as the van they drove, and the crew was soon rounded up.